The Glass Universe, How the Ladies of the Harvard Observatory Took the Measure of the Stars by Dave Asobel is a fascinating story about discoveries, new ideas, and the pioneering women who changed astronomy in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. At the center of this story are the women computers of the Harvard College Observatory, a group of women who, against the gender norms of their time, found a place for themselves in the male-dominated world of astronomy. These women were hired at first to do simple jobs, but they went on to make important contributions to our understanding of the world. The title, The Glass Universe, refers to the hundreds of thousands of glass film plates that the observatory started to collect in the 1880s. These plates were used to take pictures of stars, galaxies, and other objects in space. The women computers carefully looked at, analyzed, and cataloged these plates, which together made up a glass universe. Wilhelmina Fleming, a Scottish girl who became an astronomer and made a list of thousands of stars and found the Horsehead Nebula, was one of these women. Then there was Annie Jump Cannon, a deaf astronomer who organized more than 350,000 stars and helped create the method we still use today to organize stars. And let's not forget Henrietta Swan Leavitt, who found the connection between the brightness and time of Cepheid variable stars. This made it possible to figure out how far away things are in the universe. Sobel does a great job of weaving together the human stories of these women with the scientific discoveries they helped make. She shows how they fought against society's standards, how determined they were, and how smart they were, which helped them break the glass ceiling of their time. Alongside, Sobel talks about how their work was groundbreaking because they were able to figure out what the light and spectral lines on the glass plates said about the stars. A big idea in the book is how important it is to pay attention and keep trying. The women computers spent hours and hours looking at the glass plates and often did complex calculations and studies by hand. Their careful observations and ideas led to many astronomical findings, showing how important it is to observe carefully and patiently for scientific progress. The way that technology has changed science is another major theme. Astronomy changed a lot when glass plates were used to take pictures of the night sky. It made it possible to keep track of celestial bodies over time, which led to new insights about the world that had never been seen before. The women who used computers were important to this change in technology. They showed how well they could understand and use this new medium. The Glass Universe also talks about how men and women should be treated the same in science. Sobel shows through the stories of the women computers how much women can contribute when they are given a chance. Their achievements went against the ideas about men and women that were common at the time, and they still inspire women in science today. In the end, The Glass Universe is a tribute to the women in astronomy who don't get enough credit and a celebration of the human spirit of finding. Sobel paints a fascinating picture of a time when women used glass plates and a love of the stars to help us learn more about the world. The book is a good reminder of how important women have been to science progress, even though they are often forgotten. It tells us that we can figure out the mysteries of the world if we have the courage to reach out and try.